So here's the thing about the later Roman Empire. It was actually two empires. Well, if you really want to be an ass about it, it was several empires at one point, but let's save that for another time. The good old Roman Empire at one point just got a bit too big. In fact, let's not mince words, it was way too fucking big. Almost as big as your mother, even. And because of this, the Romans at the time figured they just saw the empire in half. Just cut it in two, and thus formed the Eastern and Western Roman Empires. The Western bit proceeded to explode not too long after its formation, but the Eastern bit continued on into what is now known as the Byzantine Empire. Now this is all well and good, you might be saying, but where the fuck is the Warhammer bit? Well, impatient straw man, you, I'm getting to it. See, the Imperium of Man never split in two in this manner. They couldn't fucking conceive of letting go of any of their territory if they can help it, let alone half of it. No, for this one, Games Workshop had to actually get creative with the world they built. And now, allow me to tell you how the Byzantine Empire influenced the setting of Warhammer 40K. Well, that last bit really sounded more appropriate for a documentary than a 5-ish minute YouTube video. Segues now. So when Games Workshop was creating the Imperium to be Space Rome, they didn't really account for the whole it split itself into two parts to ease the massive administrative burden thing. In the early days of the setting, it was implied that the Imperium was swiftly moving towards just falling apart, and nowadays that would result in injuring their special little baby faction, so of course they aren't gonna break the thing apart. But they apparently still felt they should acknowledge the split, and thus did we get the Imperium Secundus. For those of you without the massive, titanic brain power to figure out what that means, Imperium Secundus means Second Imperium. Wow. You see, rowboat Guilty Spark was cut off from Terra by the Ruinstorm, which was just Lorgar saying you shall not pass to all of Ultramar and locking it off from the rest of the galaxy. Rowboat Gilliman figured that if he has no idea if the rest of the galaxy had fallen or not, he'd act on the worst case assumption that it had, and Ultramar was all that remained. Now how did the real world Byzantines influence this little fuster cluck? Well, it's definitely more inspiration than copy and paste like a lot of Games Workshop creations. Here are some ways that it isn't similar to get out of the way first. First of all, the Eastern Roman Empire wasn't completely cut off from the Western half. They could trade and communicate without issues. Sure, sometimes a horde of Goths would interrupt things a bit, but there was nothing permanent like a massive goddamn hurricane of souls blocking them from each other. Speaking of massive hordes of invaders, the split didn't happen because the East thought the West had fallen or was about to fall like Gilliman thought the Imperium had. Don't get me wrong, the Eastern half was infinitely more prosperous than the Western half and they knew it, but the split didn't come about because Rome was about to fall and they wanted someone to continue on the legacy of the Empire. It was because Rome was too big by a few thousand miles and they thought it would run more smoothly if they cut it in half. And of course, unlike the Byzantine Empire, the Imperium Secundus didn't outlast the Imperium of Man at all. The moment Gilliman found out the Imperium was in fact still around, he cancelled the whole goddamn thing and rushed to Terra to aid the Emperor against Horus. The Byzantines, meanwhile, lasted almost a whole millennia after the Western Romans fell, so as you can see, there's certainly a few differences between the two. But while there's more differences than similarities, it's still easy to see that the Imperium Secundus was influenced by the Byzantines. For one, while the Imperium Secundus didn't outlast the main Imperium, it was still intended to. True, in Gilliman's mind, the Imperium Secundus was more of a posthumous continuation of the Emperor's realm, while the Eastern Romans were just Rome II coinciding with Rome I, but the idea of the Byzantines continuing on the Empire clearly influenced the creation of the Imperium Secundus, because that's exactly what the actual Byzantines ended up doing, and that's what Gilliman wanted his little project to do. It's also worthwhile to talk about the capitals of each, because that's another way the Byzantines influenced this bit of the setting. The planet of Bacrag naturally became the capital of the Imperium Secundus, as it has been stated to be one of the most valuable planets in the Imperium, behind only Terra and Mars. Now let's look at the Byzantines. Their capital became the city of Byzantium, renamed Constantinople after the Emperor Constantine the Great. It was clearly the second most valuable city in the Empire behind only Rome, and eventually was worth even more than Rome was. Compare that to modern-day Warhammer, where Macrag is a nice civilized world, and Terra is a shithole, and the influence only shines stronger. So while there certainly are a lot of differences between the Imperium Secundus and the Byzantines, in this case it's not because Games Workshop didn't draw influence from the Byzantines, but rather because for once, instead of just copy and pasting the history and changing the names, they actually did some work to make it unique. As one final little bonus influence, the Dark Imperium of current 40K lore resembles not only the Byzantine Empire, but the Tetrarchy of all things. The Tetrarchy being when Rome was divided between two senior and two junior emperors, but technically was still a part of the same empire. They divided into the four sections and each emperor didn't bother the other three, but they would all pretend it was still the same on a map. As for the 40K influence, it resembles the Byzantines because the Imperium has been cut in half by the Great Rift, though not voluntarily like the Romans, and it resembles the Tetrarchy because Gilliman is ruling half with Terra in it, while Dante is ruling the half that absolutely sucks to live in. More so than the Imperium, you know, already sucks to live in. There's only two instead of four major rulers like the actual Tetrarchy, but hey, Games Workshop can't copyright actual history. So there's the Byzantine Empire and how it affected Warhammer 40K. I hope you enjoyed reading this essay as much as I enjoyed writing it. Thanks for watching, and take care. I couldn't figure out a funny or even related to the video way to include that the Byzantines had fucking flamethrowers mounted on their ships over 1,000 years before the World Wars, but yeah, they did. Isn't that awesome? Imagine being a pirate about to raid a group of merchant ships only to hear the loot cover of Fortunate Son and your ship starts to melt.